Welcome to another video on the EigenChem channel, where we help you learn chemistry the easy way by showing you how to solve problems. This is a video in our Fundamentals of Quantum Mechanics series. In today's video, we will talk about eigenfunction, eigenvalue problems in quantum mechanics. If you've watched some of the other videos on our channel, you know our focus is on solving chemistry problems. But this video will be a little different, because instead of solving a problem, this video will try to answer a simple question. What is an eigenfunction, eigenvalue problem anyway? But before we start, please be sure to subscribe to our channel if you want to see more content on quantum chemistry. Okay, so let's take a look at today's question. A key equation in quantum mechanics is the Schrodinger's equation, or more precisely, the time-independent Schrodinger equation, H psi equals to E psi. In mathematics, this equation is called an eigenfunction, eigenvalue problem. Let's take a closer look at what it means. Let's say our system is one-dimensional. In this case, the wave function psi is a function of x. Representing this explicitly, we have h psi of x equals to e times psi of x. On the left side, h is an operator. An operator operates on the function following it, transforming psi of x to some output function, say f of x. The right side states that the output f of x is just equal to the original psi of x, multiplied by a number e, not including zero. So to distinguish between operators and numbers, we sometimes put a special upside down V symbol above H. So what are some examples of operators? Well, here is one. d by dx, when applied to the purple psi of x function, morphs it into the green f of x function. In this example, psi of x is a cosine function, so f of x is a sine. Even though psi and f are both periodic, the purple psi of x lacks the green f of x by a quarter of a period. So you see, there's no way to multiply psi by just a number and make it come out equal to f. So we see in general, some operator operated on some function psi will usually not give back the same function. So what does it mean to solve the Schrodinger equation? It turns out that for each operator H that satisfies a certain mathematical requirement called Hermitian, you can always find a special set of functions psi that when operated on by H would give you back the same function multiplied by a number. These special functions are called eigenfunctions of the operator H. The number E corresponding to each eigenfunction is then called its eigenvalue. Let's take a look at an example. It turns out that the operator d squared dx squared is a Hermitian operator. The cosine functions are eigenfunctions of d squared dx squared. This is clear since the derivative of cosine is negative sine, and the derivatives of negative sine is negative cosine. This is shown as the green function f of x. We see that we can simply multiply psi by minus 2 and turn it into f of x. So the purple psi function is an eigenfunction of d squared dx squared. And correspondingly, there is an eigenvalue e, and this one is equal to minus 2. So the sine function solves this eigenfunction eigenvalue equation. In fact, you can easily see that not only this, but all sine functions are eigenfunctions of d squared dx squared. Let's look at another example. This operator h equals to negative d squared dx squared plus 1/2 x squared is also Hermitian. The graph shows the first three eigenfunctions of this h. There are actually an infinite set of eigenfunctions for this operator. To illustrate that these are eigenfunctions, we can take the first one, psi 1, and calculate 1/2 x squared times psi 1. This is shown in yellow. We can also calculate minus d squared psi dx squared. This is shown in red. And if we add the yellow and the red curves, we get back psi 1. In quantum chemistry, this H operator is associated with molecular vibrations and is called the harmonic oscillator. In this next example, we will return to the operator we looked at earlier, minus d squared dx squared. But this time, we will restrict the solution to be zero everywhere outside of x equals plus minus 0.5. This requirement is represented by the orange shaded regions in the graph. The eigenfunctions must be zero in these forbidden regions. The eigenfunctions are, again, sinusoidal functions, but now to satisfy the special boundary condition, they are cosine functions of half integer periods, that is, 1/2, 3/2, 5/2 periods, etc., that fit within the allowed region. And at the same time, sine functions of integer period, that is 1, 2, 3 periods, etc., that fit within the allowed region. Again, there are an infinite number of eigenfunctions for this eigenfunction eigenvalue problem that also meets the special boundary conditions here. In quantum chemistry, this is called the particle in a box problem, and this is the simplest example of quantum confinement. In general, the solutions to an eigenfunction eigenvalue problem will depend on three things. One, the eigenfunctions are different for different Hermitian operators. Two, the eigenfunctions will depend on any boundary conditions imposed on the system. For example, while the blue function psi 3 is a solution to the particle in the box problem, this red function, whose second derivative is indeed equal to itself, is not a proper solution because it does not meet the boundary condition that psi must be zero in the forbidden regions. 3. Finally, the eigenfunctions will depend on dimensionality of the problem. You have seen that these are the eigenfunctions of the particle in a box problem in 1D. But here are some of the eigenfunctions in 2D when the particle is trapped inside a circular disk. I hope this video has helped you understand in a more visual way what an eigenfunction eigenvalue problem is in quantum mechanics. If you want to see some of the mathematics worked out in detail in some eigenfunction eigenvalue problem examples, please check out some of our other videos on the channel. I'll make a link to a couple of them at the end of this video. And if you have enjoyed this video, please like this video and subscribe to our channel to get notifications on future videos in our upcoming series, Making Sense of the Quantum Realm.